Hey guys, it's Mario from WKTL, and today we're going to talk about tips on how to throw a knife. So the main things that we're going to go over are the types of wood that we're going to use. We're going to talk about the differences of end grain, poplar, cottonwood. We're also going to talk about how to hold a knife, how the rotations work, and how WKTL has two different rotations that we're working off of, starting from the 10-foot mark and from the 15-foot mark. We're going to jump right into it, and it's no different than axe throwing. You want to minimize movement. You want to be square. So the idea is, with axe throwing, for precision, what you don't want is you don't want an arm coming across. You don't want to be doing a baseball throw. That is an inconsistent throw that you're going to have a hard time honing in on. But when you square up, when you have your elbows tucked in, and it is a straight motion, similar to throwing a dart, it becomes much easier and much more repeatable. And so the difference is we have now less than a quarter inch to really stick the knife in with the tip, as opposed to maybe the 4 inches that you have on an axe. Now, to throw a knife, again, you want to make sure your feet are planted, be square, minimize movements, keep the elbow tucked in. So once you are square and you're minimizing the movement, you're then able to create a throw that is very repeatable. So again, you're minimizing the amount of throw. I'm using a pinch grip, which we'll talk about very soon. And you release. So there, I over-rotate, and we'll talk about how to fix the over-rotations depending on the knife that you're throwing. So next up, grip. The most popular grip right now is the hammer grip. And a lot of axe throwers grip an axe the same way as they would a knife. Now, just because you're holding it like a hammer doesn't necessarily mean that you have to throw it like one either. When you release the hammer throw and all of the releases, you literally just want to let the knife go. So when you're holding it like a hammer, it's literally what it sounds like. You have a good grip on the axe, or on the knife, sorry. And what will happen is, with a hammer grip, you should expect it to rotate faster. So a hammer grip does have much more rotation. You lock your wrist in, you do the hammer grip, and you release. Now, the other grip that you can do is a pinch grip. So what I do is I keep the knife inside my fingers, I wrap it around, and I'm barely pinching it. Those who are familiar with the grip, or with the axe throwing technique called the Canadian flick, this is no different, except you're locking the wrist. It's a pinch grip, but you're not flicking it. Knife throwing is so much more difficult than axe throwing because you have less coverage to work with. You are no longer using 4 inches where you can get away just flicking the axe and having the axe rotate. With a knife, it's much more difficult. So you have to use the pinch grip, but you have to lock the wrist to let it in. So again, pinch grip, you're gripping it on the insides, you're barely gripping the thumb in there, and you simply pull it back, release. The final one that I'm going to show you is a combination of the hammer and the pinch grip, but you put the thumb behind the knife. So it's no different. You still put it on the insides of your fingers, you wrap the finger around, and you just have the thumb in the back. So again, no different. I'm gonna do a single rotation example. I'm gonna have the thumb on the inside of the handle, and I'm going to release. So with the thumb, because you're pushing it with your thumb, you're forcing that rotation to go faster. It's very similar, and you'll see how the knife over-rotated slightly instead of straight, and it's not the end of the world that it did that, but you can expect a faster rotation with the hammer grip or with the thumb on the back when you are pushing and releasing. It almost forces you to flick in a way. So those are the three main types of grips: hammer, pinch, thumb behind the knife. So for WKTL, there's going to be different boards that you're going to be throwing on. And this is the thing that makes it interesting about the sport. We do not only use logs or allow for logs or only end grain targets. The majority of WKTL facilities will actually have cottonwood or poplar. So it'll be a combination of the two. Both are very soft wood, and you'll see, you've seen with some of the throws that I've been doing, that they stick no problem. And they actually last a decent amount of time. I've been using this for several weeks now. Now, in saying that, these boards are much harder than end grain, and they're much harder than logs that you would normally put up. And that's a different type of a challenge, and part of why the knives are a bit sharper on the edge to accommodate and allow for slightly harder boards. You might even end up throwing on pine. all of them are allowed under WKTL rules and under WATL rules. So not only are they excellent for axe throwing, but they're also great for knife throwing. And so on cottonwood, it's no different than really throwing on different end grain type targets. They stick quite nicely, and it's actually quite simple and easy to make it stick because some of the knives already come nice and sharp. So these are the type of main bores that we're going to be using in WKTL. You'll see differences and variances. The main thing that matters is that you have a wood board that follows WKTL target regulations. We are no longer only going to say you must use SPF, you know, spruce, pine, fir, you must only use cottonwood, you must only use poplar. You can use whatever you want, including the end grain targets and including logs, as long as this is all regulation. So now we're gonna talk about rotation control. There's several elements that help you control the rotation of all the knives that you throw. So the first one's gonna be simple, is distance. So if I am under rotating, assuming, let's say the 10-foot line is right in front of me, and I am still under rotating, you can actually step closer as long as you do not cross the 10-foot mark. So a lot of players, including myself, for two rotations, we have the rules of 15 feet minimum, but I actually throw closer to 17 or 16 and a half feet, so I will take a step back. If I'm under rotating, for me to fix that, I just step forward, where, well, that one bounced out, but I had an under rotation because the tip did not stick in. And so the quick fix for that is I'm not gonna adjust my throw, I'm not gonna do anything with the way I grip the handle, I'm simply going to step forward. So now that I'm forward, right at the 10-foot mark, I can release and I no longer have that under rotation. The previous throws were landing like this, which ultimately affected and hit the guard at that angle, couldn't get the tip in and it bounced out. So that's the first way of fixing an under rotation, step forward. The other way to fix rotation and do rotation control is if you're holding it high, all you have to do is, actually let me show you, all you have to do if you're holding it high, all you have to do is hold it lower. The lower you hold it, the more rotation you get. So again, I'm gonna be at the exact same spot, so about 10 and a half feet from where I was, and I'm gonna hold it lower, and you'll notice, oh, see, I held it so low that it actually over-rotated. So I overcompensated a bit too much and I went too low. So that's the other way to control for rotation. The final way to control rotation is force. So what that means is, if I hold it the same way, and I'm gonna throw from the same place as when I missed the first throw, I'm just gonna put more force to it. When you add more force, you're essentially providing less distance for the knife to rotate. So instead of under rotating, I'm gonna force it in so it rotates a bit faster. So that should have been a complete under rotation, like the first one, where it bounced out, but because I applied more force, it was able to rotate much quicker when I pushed it through. So everything that I mentioned holds true if you want to slow down the rotation. So if it's over rotating too much, we previously said, if you want more rotation, hold it lower. If you want less rotation, hold it higher. That holds true. If you want more rotation, tilt it back. If you want less rotation, tilt it forward. We said if you're over rotating, step forward. If you're under rotating, take a step back. All these things are small little tips and tricks that you may have to do during a match. Now, again, it should be to a point where you found your position, you're comfortable, you have a repeatable throw, and if you're over or under rotating, it should just be some of these slight tweaks that you might need to do instead of repositioning yourself throughout a match. All right, so just keep in mind for WKTL, we have the two distances, we have the 10-foot minimum, and we have the 15-foot minimum. So single rotations, you wanna do from the 10-foot mark, line yourself up. I'm gonna take a step forward, that one over-rotated a bit. And I'm gonna work my way up towards that bullseye again. Missed it, I'm gonna work my way down. And now I'm gonna go for the final one in the middle. And that's the tough part of WKTL, where you have existing knives in there and you also have the guards in place. It rotated, finished rotating here, it hit a bit of the guard, kind of dangled and it went down. So that's the single rotation. you'll see all of these, when I made the adjustments, they all landed in straight. And that's ultimately what you want to achieve, because what you don't want to do is you don't want the knife to stick like this and then have the subsequent one try to go around it, because what that's going to do is you're going to end up having this one drop, kind of like what happened with me, and you're going to end up ultimately dropping that one with the force, and you're only going to end up with two knives on the board. So you have to be very smart on how you throw and in what order you want to do it. I like to start from top down. And now if you over rotate or under rotate, that's going to change the strategy on what you do on the board. You might want to play it safe and go to the sides and maybe stick with fours if the whole bullseyes are completely blocked out. But the rotation theory, the grip, the stepping back, stepping forward, you saw some of the adjustments that I was slowly making in order to kind of achieve that. Even though I missed those two other ones because I had existing ones in the way, they help in order to actually get you to make sure you stick the knife straight. The final one that we're going to do is the double rotation. Now that's going to be a lot harder because you're throwing, I personally know most knife throwers are actually throwing closer to the 17 foot mark. So I'm going to line myself up at roughly around the 16 and a half foot mark to see how well this lines up with the knives. And that one, it looks like it slightly under rotated. So I'm going to adjust my grip. I'm going to hold it lower. And that seemed to have fixed it. So I went lower, and what I did is I put more force into it. I leaned on it to help it rotate. And that one I slightly missed. But you'll see how the adjustments come into play. The first one I completely missed. I saw it was an under rotation, so I took a quarter of a foot step forward. I actually even increased my throw, so I actually made three adjustments. I stepped forward, I tilted the knife back a bit, and I also used more force while holding the handle lower. That allowed me to get these, the subsequent one, pretty straight. These ones still under rotated a bit, so I needed to apply a bit more power in order to get them to stick more straight on. But that's ultimately some of the adjustments that you're gonna have to make during the game. So hopefully these tips help. Let us know if you have any questions in the comments, and we'll be happy to guide you in the right direction. Hope you guys enjoyed WKTL, and thanks for listening, everyone.